never wanted the easy path.
Don't. Dwega! Slashed me! Poison!
Dwega society is shrouded in mystery. Nothing useful comes to mind.
Helping me. You're a drow. No arguments there. Felt like a hook horror was sorting through my guts. But that cure did the trick. Quick sharp too.
I thank you for your help, but I gotta get moving.
Oh, it hurts.
Gull's garters. Oh, I don't have time for this. My kin need me. Seems you're the helping kind. All right. I need you to rescue my kin. Not charity, mind. We can pay. We're Ironhand Clan. Best artificers in Baldur's Gate. We were on an expedition down here when the Dwergar snatched us up. I got away, but not the others. The Greys have them digging out some old ruin across the lake. Just mining for materials. Nothing unusual. But our work pays well. Help my clan, and we'll make it worth your while. I swear. Thank you. Only wish I could go with you. But here... I nabbed these boots from the Greys when I ran. I'll feel better knowing you're using them to kick some Dwergar ass. I'll mark where I made my escape, and wait here, I suppose. Not much choice, eh?
The Myconid denounces your theft. It means to punish you. The Myconid calms. You may go in peace.
A drow? Play nice, or these shrooms will be on you in a flash. Now, doubt you'd care to notice, but you didn't see a dwarf on your travels, did you? Balin's his name. Bald, blue tunic, dumb as a stick. Right, never mind.
What's next, I wonder?
Where am I needed?
Don't be shy.
Seems the shrooms are letting in more people every day. You see a fella on his own on your way in. Dwarf. Balin's his name.
Be enough.
What to do. Seems like a good moment to talk.
Well? Well? Wits and blades, always sharp.
Sharp as ever. Have a lot on my mind.
Well?
Well.
Where are you?
I have to keep going. Always room for more.
Keen eyesight, the hole below you soon plummets into an abyss of impossible darkness. Your call echoes as it plunges downward before gradually fading away.
That tree. Something's off.
Still fresh.
I can't say what.
Something with massive claws made this.
Pride of the gate. Stop me yet. Played at the ready. Let's move. If not over, then through. I'll take that. This sensation. These flowers are absorbing all the magic in the air.
Two steps at a time.
Can't give up.
again. can't stay idle. Love comes easy these days. I'll strike you down. open up. Don't waste a step. I should speak up.
The dog wags his tail, a small bag clenched between his teeth. Gives in and surrenders his find to you.
There's something I want to talk to you about. Something important. I could have died in that pod, back on the Nautiloid. You could have died, spending precious moments trying to free me, but you did it anyway. I owe you my life. Twice over, in fact. You supported me against Lazel. I may not have survived that night without you. I'm trying to say that you've earned my trust in a way very few ever have. I want that to mean something. I want you to know more about me, at least from what I can remember. As long as I've prayed to Lady Shah, I've wished to serve her as a Dark Justiciar. There is scarcely a greater way to fully dedicate yourself to Lady Shah, save perhaps if you become the head of her church. To become a Dark Justiciar is to become the Night Singer's sword arm, her implement with which she will cast down the unbelievers and win the final battle to restore her perfect, endless darkness. It's all I ever wanted. I prayed it was my calling, but Mother forbid me from seeking to prove myself worthy of the rank. She said I was not ready. Not my mother, I should add. The Mother Superior, head of Lady Shah's enclave in Baldur's Gate. Sometimes I wonder if she would ever deem me ready. I owe her everything, and I only wish to serve, yet she can prove inscrutable. Don't know. Perhaps if I succeed in my mission and reach Baldur's Gate, hope has little place amongst Lady Shah's children. It's an illusion, a distraction. But for this, I hope my time will yet come.
Thank you.
take you.
Can't even catch my breath. Swift as my feet can carry me. Light on my feet. Let's see.
The rock under your feet juts upwards, forming a perfectly engraved tombstone with a small epitaph. In memory of Myrna, a shining light in this dark world, may you forever gaze upon the lake you love to play in. As you dig, you slowly expose the skeletal remains of a large dog wearing a chunky leather collar.
Strange collar. It's got runes all over it. I wonder what they say.
The ground in front of this tombstone has been dug up, exposing the scattered skeleton of a large dog.
Strange collar. It's got runes all over it. I wonder what they say.
Oh.
We'll fit in my pack.